Information is probably the most powerful force in the universe. On a very, very, very simple level, information can be as little as positive or negative, on or off, yes or no, one or zero. That might not sound like much, but with two states, you can portray any type of information, granted you have enough. This is information theory. This is how computers work. In computing, we call a 1 or a 0 a bit. There are 8 bits in a byte. Your average 1 terabyte hard drive has 1,099,511,627,775 bytes. That's 8,796,093,022,208 instances of either a 1 or a 0. Somewhere in that intricate system, something will go wrong.
Do you know what incorrect editing is?
What?
Glitch art is the term given to art created by making breaks in computer systems. Disturbances in electronics from as far back as the 1970s have frustrated and wounded people, from a perhaps elite few to the masses thanks to the rise of the internet. Glitch art has risen as a new form of art. Some people say that it has no meaning. Abstract colours and shapes leave little to imagine. Some even say that if art is as easy as screen capping a fault in the system, it isn't art. But yet, beauty can be found in abnormality. Some artists break into their systems, using their extensive knowledge to break the computer in a very specific way. Some even add meaning, with the connotations artifacts have, and the use of photography and glitch. With the use of fragments of emails, messages, and even personal data, the artist can show a very real side to their art. Personal, social, and political ideologies can be thrown around with glitch as much as any other art form. Glitch art can be achieved in two ways, finding it in the wild or a set of processes called data bending. Data bending is the process of breaking into a piece of media, finding the information that makes it up, and messing with it. That is what I'm about to do. Making computer programs would be impossible with the amount of information you would have to sift through if you were coding at the bit level. Instead, computers are layered with code. Each level of encoding makes the information a little easier to read. You could look at it like this. Behind an image is a set of instructions that the pixels in your monitor read and then spit out the image. Behind those, a set of instructions on how to write the instructions. Eventually, we get back down to the ones and zeros. If you were to tamper with a set of instructions to bake a cake, then when that cake was made, it would be made in a different way to the way the instructions said it should before they were tampered with. So if I was to break into the information that tells my computer how to read an image and delete lines of code, the computer would read that image differently. That is one method. It's called incorrect editing, opening a file up in a piece of software intended for a different file format. It works with other programs and files too, opening image files in audio editing software, for instance. Another word for this is reinterpretation. There are other, more technical ways of bending data too. Forced errors are when files are coded specifically to come out broken. This requires a lot of technological know-how. In fact, it is this that makes glitch art somewhat hard to interpret. As shown earlier, not many people are aware of glitch as an art form. There is much debate whether it is in fact an art form for that matter.
The most glitchy experience I've ever had programming is programming for the Game Boy Advance, where characters and memory space is very limited, so if you assign the wrong character to the wrong space of memory, it really messes up how code works. So you have squares taken up by the wrong characters, so you have apps all over the screen, different colours everywhere, and like smiley faces appearing when there weren't even any smiley faces in our code. Yes, I think that the whole development of video games development is art as much as actually the games themselves, I think. So any glitch or any like error that happens during that process is always really interesting, and the art of how it appeared and the art of solving it as well is always really interesting, and what it looks like as well can also look really good. Every glitch represents something that wasn't found in the code, and it also represents a process that someone has undertaken to find that glitch and expose it in a way that causes such problems that the programmer didn't expect. So having something like, whether it's missing though from Pokemon or something more recent, is really interesting how it appears in the code when no one's actually told it to be there.
Computers were invented to process documents and do scientific calculations, a desktop of folders and files. To experiment creatively with such a device is to work against the material. By working with the grain of the current media, glitch deconstructs artworks looking for meaning, celebrating uncertainty, mishap, and creative misuse.